everybody, it's time once again for another Godzilla figure review. Godzilla-thon is still on hold, believe it or not, and I figure might as well do this guy before, you know, the whole G-Fest thing. You know, I just might as well get him out of the way. But not really, I'm talking about this guy, the Movie Monster Series, 6-inch, scaled-down, pink tag, Mechagodzilla 3, or Kiryu. The name is longer than he himself. But anyway, this guy is... okay. So when we first heard that Bandai was scheduled to, you know, re-release some of the standard figures in 6-inch form, we thought it'd probably be kind of cool, but we were having mixed feelings. Now personally, I love the 6-inch series, even a little bit more than the standard ones, just because of its nostalgic value and their playability value when I was a kid. But these guys... I don't really hit the spot as much as the old ones did, the older 6-inch figures did, and I really can't tell why. It may just be because that we were used to these giant figures as being giant figures, and now they're small, and it's kind of weird. But anyway, that's pretty much all about, that's pretty much his background. What about the figure himself on his own merits? The paint job seems to be pretty well done. Obviously, most of it's going to be silver, but with little bits of black here thrown in between the joints, just like the standard size figure. But unlike the standard size figure, it's kind of tiny, but that's sort of obvious. But really, if I was going to just guess, I would say this looked quite a bit like it, and it just, you know, from a distance, it actually does look kind of like the standard figure. It's only when you get up kind of close and you see that the detail starts to kind of wear down. Although this is nicely riveted and sculpted and everything in there, it still just lacks the depth that the other one did, the old one did. And even though you can even see individually sculpted teeth in there, and the eyes look really nice, and even the little arm gauge or whatever that is down there looks pretty cool too, it's just things aren't quite as sharp and clean as they were. The fingers are dull, the claw or the drill is dull, down to his feet and everything, just dull, dull, dull. But it looks really nice and sculpted, but like I said, just not quite as good as the old one. By the way, the tag on this guy is like all the reissue figures and scaled-down figures, which was a pink tag. Now, these figures are not quite as expensive and very easy to find as the old 6-inch figures. It's just a pink tag with Kiryu on the front, and then on the inside a different picture, and then on the back, Godzilla screaming in front of flames. And that's pretty much how they all go. Even the reissues of the old 6-inch figures, which have pink tags. Same thing with this guy. Articulation on this guy is actually very similar and reminiscent of the standard size figure, and maybe one of the only things it has up on it. Because you can see as his head moves very well and very freely, so do his arms very well and very freely. And also his tail. But it doesn't have a middle joint like the standard size figure, which is what sets it apart. But the thing is, if you move this guy, you don't feel like you might just break him. And although I know the old one was soft vinyl, I just always felt like it was going to do something bad if I moved him too much. And this guy, you can move around a lot. I mean, he's just movable, you know? You move him. But that may be the only leg up this thing has over the standard figures, that it may not be a tragedy if it breaks. Now, as far as size comparison with this guy goes, I don't have a 6-inch Millennium Godzilla figure with me currently, right now. But I do have another Millennium figure, which is a little different, but still kind of goes with him. Yeah, here is the Gamera 2006, Gamera the Brave. As you can see, Mechagodzilla actually is a little taller than him, which makes sense since he should be a little taller than Godzilla. And Godzilla's gotta be taller than this little guy. As you can see, Gamera just looks a little too big and puffy next to this very finely toned and riveted, ripped monster that he is. So we'll just take him out of the scene. Really, the thing about this guy is that he doesn't really scale with anything, and that's kind of the downside once again with him. Now, you can say he scales well with the other reissued 6-inch Millennium figures like Gigan and Mothra, but really, they weren't even that good either, so it's kind of like he has to be scaled to the right thing just so he can be okay, but the things he's scaled to aren't all that great either. It's just kind of a sad story all the way around for this fairly okay figure. Final verdict on this guy then. I would have to say, just don't even bother with him. I mean, if you want to complete a complete 6-inch Godzilla figure line, then you will have to get this guy, obviously. He's not even a reissue. I mean, he's a brand new sculpt, pretty much. But the thing of it is, you don't need to do that, and you can get the standard size just fine. Now, I know the standard size is very expensive, and obviously, if you can't afford that, then get this guy. If you're just a huge Mechagodzilla fan, then you must get this guy. But those are the only two circumstances in which you would have to get this guy. So really, I got him because I like 6-inch figures, but it just doesn't seem like there's much to him, really. But anyway, I would say it's an okay figure, but you really don't need him, and he's not that special. And that's it for this review, and this is probably going to be my last review till G-Fest, which is just next week. In fact, a week from today, it will be the first day of G-Fest, and I will be bringing you coverage from every day of that G-Fest experience. And so I invite you to join me on my next video, which will be G-Fest Day 1.